Students, I am Parvati. I am a physics teacher from Oxford High School, Uppugunduru. Today I will explain about the lesson light. Light is an invisible energy which causes the sensation of vision. The main property of light is rectilinear propagation of light. Rectilinear motion means each and every particle should be travels in straight line path. Okay, each and every particle must be travels in a straight line path. For example, take a torch light. Torch light produces a parallel beam of light, not a single ray of light, ma beam of light. Beam means a collection of rays. Torch light produces the parallel beam of light. Take the torch light into the dark room. We have to see the beam of light. Okay, each and every particle should travels in a straight line motion. That straight line motion is called as a rectilinear propagation of light. Example, torch light. And next, we are going in a vehicle, that is a car. The car headlights produces the parallel beam of light. That parallel beam of light is seen in misty night. Misty night means which restricts the visibility. Okay. And next, what is the importance of light? Light which causes the sensation of vision. The main properties of the light is reflection and reflection. Okay, Amma? Reflection. Reflection means light comes back into the same medium, or returning of light in the same medium is called as reflection. For example, take the ball. The ball is moved towards the wall. After that, for example, if you take the ball and hit the wall with a some angle, and say if the ball is reflected into the same angle in opposite direction. In the same way, the light is incident on the any object or any material, the same light is reflected and enter into eye. We are getting a feeling of we are seeing the object. Okay, na? A reflection means the returning of light, the bouncing back of light is called as a reflection. My reflection, these are the two types of reflections is there. The first one is regular reflection. Regular reflection. And the second one is irregular reflection. Regular reflection and irregular reflection. Two types of reflections are there. The first one is regular reflection and the second one is irregular reflection. My regular reflection is always takes place on smooth surfaces like highly polished surfaces. Okay, now regular reflection is always takes place on smooth surface, that is highly polished surface. Example is plane mirror. Highly polished is the surface. Example is plane mirror. Irregular reflection is always takes place on rough surface. Rough surface. Irregular means up and downs. Irregularities means up and downs. Irregular reflection is always takes place rough surface. Example for rough surface is wood, pan, next grass, next screen. These are all rough surfaces. The reflection should be takes place on these rough surfaces. That reflection should be called as irregular reflection. What is reflection and what is the importance of the reflection is, for example, reflection is always takes place in one media, not in single media. Now this is a boundary. Boundary means separating the two media. First one rarer and the second one is denser. Now rarer means the speed of light is very high, that is a rarer. Speed of light is very high, that is a rarer medium. Denser means the speed of light is very less, that is denser. Okay, here this is the boundary. Boundary means separating the two media. For example, this is the sun. Sun is always produces the light energy. Okay, na? Here the light which is comes from the sun and which is incident on the surface. Okay. Those light which are incident on the surface, that light ray should be called as incident ray. Okay, now, ma, this is boundary surface. And next one, this indicates coating. Coating. coated surface. Coated surface means there is no reflection takes place. We know plane mirror. One side of the plane mirror is highly polished, and the another side of the plane mirror is incident ray, normal. Okay, now after that, the light ray is reflected into the same medium. The light ray is reflected into the same medium. This is called reflected ray. This is called reflected ray. Okay, now ma, here incident ray, normal, and reflected ray. Here the angle between incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence. Angle of incidence is represented by the letter small I. Angle between normal and incident ray is called angle of incidence, that is represented by I. And next one, the angle between the normal and the reflected ray is called angle of reflection, that is represented by R. Okay, now amma, incident ray, normal, and the reflected ray. Those ray which are incident on the plane surface is called as incident ray. Draw the perpendicular line from the point of incidence. This is the point of incidence, that is called normal. The ray which is reflected from the surface, it is called as reflected ray. Plane surface means highly polished surface, that is the reflections only takes place that place only. Okay, now and next one, this is the plane surface and this is the incident ray. The angle made by the incident ray with the plane surface is called as angle of glancing. Glancing angle is represented by the letter alpha. Glancing angle is represented by the letter alpha. The angle made by the incident ray with the plane surface is called glancing angle. Okay, now ma, if the incident ray is extended into the another medium, that is the denser medium, denser medium. Here, the angle between the reflected ray and extended incident ray, angle between reflected ray and extended incident ray is called angle of deviation. It is represented by the small d. Okay, now ma, this is extended incident ray. Extended incident ray. Ma, see ya. This is incident ray. These are directly coming from this sun. This is extended incident ray. That way, we are right dotted path. Extended incident ray. Here, the angle between reflected ray and extended incident ray is called angle of deviation. Okay, glancing angle, angle of incidence, angle of reflection, and the angle of deviation. Okay, now ma, here the relation between angle of incidence and the angle of reflection and the angle of deviation is angle I plus angle R plus angle D is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, now these are all 180 degrees. These are all represents 180 degrees. The angle between angle of incidence, angle of reflection, and the angle of deviation is 180 degrees. Ma, reflection is takes place on smooth surface or curved surface. Smooth surface means like, curved surface means like this. Okay, na? Reflection is always takes place any surface, either it is a smooth surface or rough surface or plane surface or curved surface. Here, the different angles are measured from this diagram. Relation is angle of incidence plus angle of reflection plus angle of deviation is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, now, what is the loss of reflection? Ma, these are only two laws is there for the reflection of light. The first law is equal to, the first law is the angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. The angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. And the second one is incident ray, normal, and the reflected ray. See once again, incident ray, normal at the point of incidence and reflected ray should lie on the same plane, not in outer plane, same plane. These are the two laws for the reflection of light. Incident ray, incident, normal at the point of incidence, and next one, reflected ray. Reflected ray. These are all present in the same plane. These are the two laws of reflection of light. Reflection means light comes back into the same medium. Light is reflection is always takes place in one media, that is a rarer or a denser. Rarer means the speed of light is very high, and the denser means the speed of light is very less. You know one thing, the speed of light in air is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, or 3 × 10⁻¹ centimeter per second. The speed of light in air is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, and speed of light in vacuum is 3 × 10⁻¹ centimeters. Okay, na? And next one, ma, this is the normal. How to draw the normal to the plane surface or curved surface? How to draw the normals to the plane surface and curved surface? Ma, plane surface means the surface is highly polished. Ma, this is the plane surface. Only reflection is takes place only upper side of this surface only. This is there is no reflection takes place on this surface. Okay, na? Ma, this is the plane surface. The reflection is takes place. Normal means it is a normal. It makes 90 degrees to the plane surface. That is, it is a normal. It makes 90 degrees to the plane surface. How to draw the normals to the curved surface? Curved surface means bent. Bent. This is the plane and this is curved. Curved or spherical. Curved means bent surface. How to draw the normals to the bent surface? Okay, na, amma? This is plane surface. Here, this is the normal. It makes 90 degrees to the angle. How to draw the normals to the curved surface? This is curved surface. Okay, na? Masira? This is the plane surface. Non-coated surface means there is no reflection takes place. And this is the normal. And this is the normal. And this is the normal. Spherical surface means any surfaces which is having a bent or bend. It is called spherical surface. This is the spherical bent surface, amma. Okay? Here, this is coated surface means there is no reflection takes place. The reflection should take place only in inner side. Okay, na? If the reflecting surface is the inner side or hollow side, this reflection should be, this mirror should be called as a concave mirror. Okay, na? Here, the reflection takes place only in inner side. This mirror should be called as a concave mirror. And next, if the coating is placed inside, there is no reflection takes place in an inside. Only outer side the reflection should be takes place. If the reflecting surface is outer side, then its mirror should be called as a convex. Convex mirror or convex surface, whatever it is. If the reflection is takes place in inner side, this is concave surface. If the reflection is takes place in outer side, this is a convex surface. Convex and concave means bent surface. Spherical mirror or spherical surface, it is nothing but bent surface. Spherical mirrors or the spherical surfaces are two types. First one is concave and the second one is convex. Okay? Hollow surface means concave. Outer surface, bulged out. Bulged surface means convex. How to draw the normals? These two surfaces. Now, before that, we should learn about beam, convergent beam and divergent beam. But this is the single light. The light energy must travel along its path. This is a single light. Okay? This is a parallel beam of light. Parallel beam of light. Single light. This is a parallel beam of light. The distance between these two lines, the distance between these two lines, the distance between these two lines are equal. These are the parallel beam of light. By using this one, we have to explain convergent beam and divergent beam. Convergent beam means the light rays should travel from the different directions. The light rays are coming from the different points that are meeting at the same point. that point should be called as converging point. That beam should be called as convergent beam. For example, the light rays are coming from the different directions or the different point sources. For example, this is one of the light. This is a candle. Different light rays are traveling from this candle and moving in different directions. Okay, na? This is another candle. Okay, here the light rays are moving from the different points. This is one light ray and this is the second light ray. Okay, these are meet at certain point. That point should be called as convergent. Convergent point. That beam should be called as convergent beam. Convergent beam or convergent point, it is nothing but the light rays are traveling from the different sources that are meet at the same point. That point or that beam should be called as convergent beam. Like, this is one light ray and this is the second light ray. This is the third light ray. Okay, na? First light ray, second light ray, third light ray. Actually, these are coming from these point sources. This light is coming from these point sources, and this light is coming from these point sources. These two, three different light rays are meeting at certain point. That is, these three are meet certain point. These three different light rays are meet at this certain point. These are convergent light or convergent beam. Certain point meet are at certain point. These are convergent. Okay, na? Here and next one, divergent beam. Divergent beam means they are coming from the same point but are moving with different directions. For example, this is candle. Different light rays are coming from the candle in a different directions. Light rays are coming from the different directions. They are coming from a candle but are moving in a different directions. Okay, na? That ray should be called as a divergent ray or divergent beam. For example, this is a candle. Okay, na? These are the light rays. These three light rays are coming from this candle. These are moving in a different directions. See this? These light rays move in this direction and these are moving this direction and these are moving this direction. These are called as a divergent beam. They are moving in a different directions. Okay, na? They are originating from the same point but are moving in a different directions. For example, if three are moving in different different sources but are meet at the same point, these are all called convergent beam. These are all called divergent beam and this is called plane. By using this one we have to explain how to draw the normals to the plane surface and bent surface. For example, this is a plane surface. These are all should be act as a normal. Each one should make say 90 degrees to the plane surface. Okay, na? Now, first normal, second normal, third normal. For example, if the duster is bent towards like this, here, these are all normals. Okay? Here, the inward surface is concave mirror, concave surface. These are all normals. Okay, na? Here, this is outward. Outward means bulged out. This surface should be called as convex and these are all normals. Okay, na? The normals are drawn to the convex surface or concave surface and plane surface. Okay, na? Here, convex and concave both are bent surface. Hollow surface means concave. Bulged out surface means convex. Okay, na? We are using the concave and convex mirror in real life activities. For example, we know car. The headlights of the car is prepared by the concave mirror. Why the concave mirrors are used in car headlights? car headlights is always produces the parallel beam of light. Okay, na? Concave mirror is always produces the parallel beam of light. That's why in case of car headlights we are using a concave mirror. And next, convex mirror should be act as a rear view mirror. Rear view mirror means side mirrors. Car vehicles, motorbikes, we are using side mirrors. That is convex mirrors. Convex mirrors it covers the more distance. It covers more distance with a less image. More distance or more view with a less image. It can be seen the backside vehicles clearly through the convex mirror. Okay, na? Next, convex mirrors is also used in street reflectors. And next, whereas concave mirrors are used in ENT specialist, ear, nose, throat, ENT specialist, we are using the concave mirror. In touch light also concave mirrors are used. Okay, na?